I've created a manifold block by drilling a 3/4 inch hole this way and this way until they intersect. You can see the pencil in there. Both faces have leather glued on them with the suede side out, and this will seal against this leather face on the reservoir. The relief valve is spring loaded. It's holding that shut. If the reservoir inflates too far, this trip block pushes down on this and it dumps the air, and it keeps that reservoir from overinflating. But with this just sitting in place, it's holding air pressure pretty well. The manifold block has a double leather gasket sealing against this face of the reservoir. There are two screws that go through this block and screw into the reservoir to pull that gasket tight. And then there's a leather gasket sealing with this outside face. The two pieces of duct tape are sealing the screw holes in case there's any leakage at that point. Need to use one of these spring clips for the spring on the reservoir. It's getting harder to find the good ones. And one's made in the US or UK. This one's made in Japan. I don't know if you can see it or not, but it's got their logo stamped on it. It's a blued steel. It's springy. The ones in the office supplied now seem to all be made in China. They're a painted. You can get these in silver, gold, blue, red, and even the black is painted. They don't appear to be the tempered spring steel that they were. Now this is going to operate in one of these notched pieces of wood, and this is too narrow. I was just playing with that. And I want this section in here to be wider, like this one. I've taken one of these and I've modified it to be like that. Just take that out. Take a pair of pliers and start bending on it. Starting off with the wires that looked like that, I took it a little bit further and went out, use my bench vise and a hammer to flatten these out. You want to make sure these are about the same. It doesn't take much to keep those in spring. And you want those to be about like that. Now I can use a 3/4 inch piece of wood and it'll clear and it'll be much more stable when it's in the slot, much more stable than one of these narrow ones where it can tip back and forth. The manifold block off of the reservoir comes through this side, and I have an adapter block threaded for 1/8 inch pipe thread. This is connected with the tubing to the top of this manometer and will measure the pressure when this is running. Distance from here to here appears to be 4 inches. These are not 1 inch graduations. They're actually 1 3/16, because the manometer is built to be filled with oil with a specific gravity of 0.826. So that kind of caught me off guard the first time I used this as well. Croaking noise. I've got one of these wood bearings. A little bit of a bind. If I push on the end of this shaft, it goes away. We'll fix that later. Now the reservoir is operating with this spring pressure. And in this position, it is giving me 5 inches of water. And the relief valve on the opposite side is releasing the excess air so the reservoir does not exceed its maximum extension. Now you can see that relief valve opening and closing, dumping excess air. as this operates with 5 inches of water. When I turn it off, you can see it maintains a little over 4 inches of water until the reservoir closes and the pressure goes to zero. I have run this as high as 11 inches of water. Around 11 and a half to 12 inches, it starts to stall out the drive motor.